Hey everybody, it's Mark Mifflin and Feathers again. Today I'm trying another hermit crab for you. These over for in, he's a crab. Tie them a bit bigger or smaller depending on your target species. You could tie them small for bones. This is the Grand Slam crab. So I'm tying this fairly big. This is going to Mexico for permit, and this is a size 1/0 SC15 Kamakatsu, but you can tie them from, a 2/1, 1/0, 2/0 for permit. You could go smaller, you could probably tie them in a 4 if you were going for bonefish, and obviously you can just sort of adjust the colours to suit, but I've run on a bed of chartreuse, Danvilles 210 flat wax nylon, and I'm just going to figure it on a pair of brass eyes. Get them on nice and tight. Make sure that they're nice and straight before you really lock down on them. And then just to tighten everything up, take some thread wraps around below the eye and above the shank. That tightens all the wraps up. And I'm still going to get a wee bit of super glue and just drop a wee spot on there just to help secure it. Take another couple of wraps. And then take my thread round to, and these are quite short shanked, these SC15s, the bench starts quite early, so I like to just take it just sort of around, just from the start of the bend, to get a bit level with the barb of the hook. I'm going to take two puffs of grizzly marabou, and you can moisten them slightly just to make them a wee bit easier to handle. I like these to be about the length of the hook. A wrap will hold that, and then same on this side. A wrap will hold it. So I've tied these in. One on each side, just to sort of encourages them to splay a wee bit. That's a wee bit short, that one. There we go. Sort of in a crab claw defensive sort of position. And just tighten that up. You don't need to worry too much about tidying this at this stage. Next, I'm going to take a couple of strands of polar flash. Whatever flash you like will do, but just a couple. You don't want a lot of flash, crabs are not shiny. Just a wee accent. Tie the strands on this side, take them over to the other side. That same tie then. I'm going to take some 20 pound nylon. 3 inches is plenty, 3 or 4 inches. And I'm going to tie it in the length of the shank of the hook. And And this is where you kind of start tidying up your body position and stuff. So once that's nice and covered up and fairly neat, well, so I'll just turn it in the vise just so you can see it more clearly. A bit better. It's time to tie in the eyes, and I'm just using a pair of nylon dumbbells or barbells. It's stuff you would use for like a toad or like that, and I'm just going to like bend them in the middle a wee bit. And then right snug at the base of the claws or the marabou. Just get that tied in. Could be a bit tricky to position them. Just figure eight them, same as you would any other set of eyes. There you go. And you can sort of lock it down with a couple of wraps over the figure eight there. And that gets them nicely positioned. The body, this is just a sort of American style body. About a pencil, you need a bunch of EP fibres, about a pencil width thick. Now, I don't pre-cut them, I find it easier to handle. You know, like a wee 1 inch or 2 inch strip, I think it's much more difficult to handle than if you've got a full length. So I'll offer it up three wraps in one direction, then three wraps in the other. And just trim it. Leave yourself plenty so you can trim it back later. You can get the shape you want. At this point, I'll tie in my first set of legs. Just using silly legs. And each pair of legs is half a strand off the pad. So just fold it over, cut it in the middle. Then, to make sure they're nice and level, fold it over the thread, get it in the middle, pull it down on top. Colour wraps is plenty to hold it there. And then again, we cross wrap. Another one. Then you can just, again, to position them, pull them back and wrap them over the top, and they'll sort of kick out just nice. And then we'll come in with another bunch of EP fibre. Exact same process again. Do three wraps. Turn it. Right. And you can pull it back a bit. Use your thumb, get it nice and tight, then wrap over to lock those X wraps in place. Again, careful, push your leg out of the way, make sure you don't cut it. Trim it off. And another one. Three. Then I'll after this, well, third bunch, so it's two leg. And then it's just the same again. A wee bit repetitive tying these, but nice crabs. It's always a good idea to tie these in even numbers if you can, so you don't waste any leg. You know, three legs, three strands of silly leg does two flies. So tie four, tie six, you know. They don't eat anything when they're in your box anyway, so you can just leave them there. Let's figure out in the final leg. Oh, sharp. They're really wickedly sharp, these SC15s. You need to watch your fingers. I just jabbed mine. That's just one of the... A cross that we have to bear as fly tires, I suppose. And then... I'll just take another couple of... I'm a bit thin. But that's alright. Just take another couple of bunches just to... finish off the body and cut and sort of cover the barbells, but just tying them in exactly the same. 2, 3. And that nice and even. Trim it off. Then I actually tie one over the where the eyes are clipped in, like the bottom underside of the eye. So to make sure, I always like to tie them in the same direction, just for ease of handling. I'll angle the EP fibre towards the eye. You've probably noticed already. And so you make sure your thread is on your side, right, in front of the dumbbells, so you can go across them and back, right, as if you were X-wrapping over the dumbbell eye. And then come from the other side. And you've got a bit of, you know, you don't need to worry about them moving, you've got a bit of, play here. You don't need the wraps to be super tight, because you can then pull the EP back and sort of tighten up, even though you're over the eye. And it just sort of disguises that a wee bit, gives you a sort of better shape, I think. You don't need to, if you're quite happy to have the eyes exposed, just leave them. Now at this stage, I throw in a quick couple of half hitches, and I'll just trim that, lay it long so it doesn't slip out, and then got all your legs, pull them down, because you don't want to trim these, that's a disaster. Just take a material clip, whatever you use, bulldog clips, anything. And then to get your nice crab shape, you just fold the material up so that it's nice and even. Right, you don't want it spinning, you know, if it's heavy on one side, long on one side, your fly will spin when you cast it, twist up your leader. It'll sink away at a weird angle as well, no ideal. So, that's that, nice. Nice and crabby. You can tidy it up finally later. But that's a reasonable shape. We'll just tidy a couple of wee bits up there. Right. This stage, we've got a head cement. This isn't quite thick. Over these rocks.
Okay, so once
That head cement's dried off, there's a few long straight strands there. You always got a couple that you need to sort of trim off a bit. Get the hook back in the vise, and then you make your keel. So start my thread back just at the eye of the hook, trim away the base. Any kind of long fibres, I've got a few long ones that I just try to get rid of. There we go, just to tidy up, you can come in with a lighter and singe them back, so you get a nice neat head. I mean, doesn't matter at all from a fishing point of view, but oh, it's nice to get your flies nice. So I'm just running three mil silver beads. Onto this piece of 20-pound nylon or fluorocarbon, whichever you've chosen to use. And then to get the length of the keel, I like it so that the sort of curve, like the beads are just starting to curve, and that gives you a nice sort of loop size for your keel, right, like that size. So put the tip of the nylon through the eye of the hook, pull it down to the size that you like, just starting to bend there, and then a couple of wraps just to hold it. Fold this back and tie down over the top. Nice and tight. Don't want it pulling out. Then you can come in and whip finish. Always two. And that is the Grand Slam crab. All that remains to be done, we'll just trim away this tag end of this nylon. And got another wee lob of cement over the thread wraps. Just get it well secured. Flood the eye. And then just grab a bit of scrap feather off your desk, a wee bit of hackle or something, for a wire. Just pull it through. We need to do it a couple of times if you've really been. Really been heavy, there you go. And there you have it, that's the Grand Slam crab. fairly easy pattern to tie. You're not, don't need to worry about getting hackle tip claws and stalk eyes and stuff. It's nice merkin pattern, Avalon style keel, and I know that it's certainly caught a lot of fish where it's been used, so worth tying some if you're going on a trip after permit or any crab eater. I hope you liked that. If you've not subscribed already, please do. Remember to like and share the video so that others can see it as well. Thanks very much for watching, guys. Bye.